All right, good morning. I'll give you an update injury-wise in terms of who's going to practice today and who's not. So Justin Shorter's practice window is closed. He'll remain on IR, and then everyone else, because it's a walkthrough, will practice again in some capacity today. So with that, I'll turn it over to you with your questions. Yeah, well, I mean, it's sometimes a numbers deal, right? I mean, hasn't really played most of the year. It's tough to come in and do that late in the year, and you know, so I thought he did a good job just in terms of getting himself some work in there, and sometimes it becomes a numbers thing, and then just making sure that he's totally ready to go. So a combination of both.
Sorry about that. Is Josh limited at all?
Still sore. We'll continue to take it one day at a time, but I anticipate him playing.
John, any concerns over the production of the passing game lately? Like maybe the last eight games, there's been a noticeable downturn. Yardage, there's been some mistakes, I would think. But just your level of concern about what's been happening here.
Yeah, well, I would say overall, bless you, Jimmy, we need to continue to grow as a team. Passing game being one area, just one area, but continue to grow as a team and improve. And I think that's the goal every week. And certainly there's areas we need to, you know, obviously spotlight and put our focus on and in, and that's one of them. Yeah, fundamentals overall are going to be a big part in winning games and or not winning games in that case. So it's a point of emphasis for us week to week, day to day, and it's going to continue to be. We've got to be fundamentally strong in what we're doing and how we're doing it.
When it comes to the passing game,
excuse me,
focusing on Steph, and I know, you know, you're not aware of him being injured and that it's situational, but as Joe Brady said on Monday,
well, I mean, I think there's a long list of, and it's a little bit here, a little bit there, right? It's when a team, you know, he's our number one receiver, so when a team is intent on taking a number one receiver away, they make it usually at the top of their game plan, and so then sometimes just Josh going through his progression and making sure, you know, he's going through his full progression and finding those open receivers, and at the end of the day, it's about winning, right? So I understand you guys want to make it about this thing over here, and that is important because it does help us win. At the same time, it's about making sure we're going with the ball where we need to go with the ball, and then we're moving the chains and scoring points. So that's the goal.
And just as a follow-up, how is Steph handling that? Just the drop in.
Yeah,
how much of a competitor he is?
No, he's been a true pro. And that's much appreciated. And that's not easy when you're a receiver, whether you're Steph or any receiver for that matter, who's gotten to this level. They're used to catching balls. So we'll continue to work, continue to improve, as I said, in all areas. That's the focus today.
John, just one follow-up to that. Is there something different that's happening? Because, I mean, teams have faced that type of coverage for the balance of the time he's been with the Bills and as productive as he and Josh have been together. What within that dynamic numbers?
It's probably a better question for the defenses we faced, Adam. You know, I think there's a, like I said, it's when you're on a team and there's a system and people say, hey, this is what we need to do, and then there's things that copy, defenses that copy that, and so on and so forth. So, you know, it's just us continuing to find our rhythm each game, and we take it on a one game at a time basis.
Talked to you last week about if the Dolphins scored in the stadium with this week with the Steelers being able to clinch the playoff berth on Saturday. How do you handle that? Do you watch that game? Do you pay attention to it?
Yeah, I won't watch it. We were solely focused on our level of play in the Miami Dolphins.
Coach, with Vic Fangio's defense, he seems to take away the easy answers and fight most
stakes are large. This guy's forcing you to kind of hold your water a little bit. Yeah. That's the challenge for Doug.
Yeah, I believe Vic's one of the top defensive coordinators and play callers in the NFL. He's been doing it for years, even before he became head coach in Denver. And as I've said before, I have a lot of respect for Coach Fangio and his knowledge of the game, his wisdom. He does a great job on that side of the ball, and they've got a very good defense and making sure they make you work for things. And I think that's a big piece of being a good defense.
How do you think your pass defense right now is maybe playing the best it's played all year? I mean, you have an opponent that's going to certainly test that. But
yeah.
Do you think right now that the whole unit is playing as well as it's playing all year?
It's a 1 week at a time league, Sal. I think they're doing a really good job of communicating and being on the same page, and I think that's really where it starts. So the quality of the play usually is congruent with that communication and them executing on the same page there. So I think we'll continue to take it 1 week at a time. And to this point, I think that they've done a nice job, and we've tried to. It's important that you can play good pass defense in this league, and. I think that's important with the quality of the quarterbacks we face week in and week out.
On that same note, what's allowed Rasul to fit in so quickly and so well the way that he has? And is that common that you see a player come over midseason and step right in the way that he has?
Yeah. Well, I would say for Rasul and LJ, both, their personalities lead, they help with that, the way that they're just naturally gifted in that way with some gist of that it factor. And it does take time, though, whether you're Rasul or LJ or anybody else, for that matter, to your point. So, and I give our building credit too for helping them acclimate themselves. So it's kind of both, I guess. And it's just fun. It's been fun to watch both of those players who came over around the trade deadline get more and more comfortable with their surroundings and letting their personality show a little bit more. No, it's he's solely focused on whatever that game is and this game with the Dolphins, and that's where he needs to be focused this week. And what's happened in the past is in the past, and this game will stand alone.
How much do you think he can draw though from those other games of what he's been able to do?
Well, there's only been one really with Coach Fangio, so I think that again makes for a small sample in this case.
End of the drought, played a lot of football for you. Played hurt. You had them back together last week. I know it's probably taken up a lot of your time to summarize what they've meant for this defense, but if you could,
yeah.
How could you?
Great question. Yeah, well, we need about an hour to talk about it. I'm just biased, probably, but I just feel. So indebted to those guys coming in 7 years ago, as you said, and the work that they've done, work that they've put in that nobody sees, even I don't see sometimes, and how important this team, this organization is to them, and to watch them run out of the tunnel the other day was, along when they grabbed Taren to run with them, was, I think that just says everything about who they are as people and who they are as professionals, and they've just done a fabulous job. If I knew then that they would go on to do what they've done over those 7 years, is we hit the lottery a little bit right there. So,
how would you say that they have done this year? Obviously both have dealt with some injuries, Mike, but most recently.
Yeah.
Where would you say individually you see them this season?
Well, I think this season has been better than last season in terms of their availability, with Micah missing most of the season last year, then Jordan being somewhat in and out, I would say, respectfully there. And now this season, Micah in and out a little bit, but for the most part, Jordan being available. And I just know how important that is to both of them to be out there with their guys leading from the front at times and leading, from the back too as well. And, just fun to watch those two work together to accomplish a common goal.
Responding from what happened, how that came in.
Yeah, they're a resilient group. They really are. The resolve that they've shown through the course of the year, beyond, you know, as you said, after the Denver game, but even before that. You know, every season, as I've said, has its own signature, takes on its own life. And I think the key is just to continue to take it 1 week at a time, continue to learn, grow, improve. And when you can do that, you're going to give yourself the best chance moving forward. If I knew what exactly has been different, we would have done it in the beginning. Our team, I believe, has played good ball. Even through the first, call it two-thirds or so of the season, or three-fourths of the season, we just, you know, we're finding, continue to find, to learn how to find ways to win. It's not always perfect, and I think that that stick-to-itiveness of the team is now starting to come to the surface, and I think that's important. When you can go in there and not have your fastball and hang in there, right? And I think that's the last two games we've been behind early in the game, and they've been able to collectively to take a breath and find their way through it. I think that's important.
Sean, there's 18-2 in December and January suggests that's a larger, you know, issue. That's a sample size,
yeah.
Right? And I know you give credit to players and everything, but is there something you try and instill in them, or is there a constant that's allowed you to deliver as you have as a team and organization in a year like this?
Yeah. I cut my hair a little bit shorter maybe in December, right? No, I think our staff does a great job. The players do too, and you know, they know what time of year it is. So I think that's probably just more of what they're doing more than anything.
Sean, your defense has faced Tyreek Hill a lot over the last several seasons. He's closing on 30 years old, maybe having his best season of his career. How impressive is it what he's done this season?
Yeah, he's unique. I mean, there's in my 20 some years in the NFL. There's no one else like him that I've seen in terms of what he can do on the field, what he's been able to do this year. And so the utmost respect for his game.
Sean, your blitz frequency has been up the last month or so. What makes that style something that fits for your personnel?
I think learning how to blitz is a part of the growth of a defense also. And maybe in years past we weren't a heavy blitz team, and I think that's just a part of being a good defense is you have to know how to blitz and have the details that lead to the execution. And so I've been impressed with how our players have soaked that up in terms of learning that along the journey of the season so far.
Is part of that too learning how to scheme a blitz? Because it seems like what you're doing in that part of the game has been more and more creative the further we've gotten in the season.
Maybe so. I don't really know. I think I give the credit to the staff and the players is taking the game plan and then into the meeting rooms and coaching it, teaching it to the nth detail, and the players taking it and taking ownership of it and being able to execute that on the field is really what I think is happening. Good. All right. Thanks, guys.